It's like the dumbest thing I've ever done.
Certainly, in its very early years, Bandon Trails was, I'm sure quite a number of people perceived it as the third course. It's not on the ocean, you know, but, it's proven itself pretty well.
When someone asks me what I think of Bandon Trails, I would say nature. It's a natural, comforting experience.
Mike, when he first called, he was very candid about it. He just said, Bill, you and Ben may not be interested in this. It's not on the ocean. It's going to be perceived as the course not on the ocean.
You probably know that Bill and Ben heard from all their friends and advisors, don't take the third course job. You're getting a less good site. And it was. What I offered them initially was in the woods. So it would have been 18 holes in the forest.
I remember saying to Mike then, I said, Mike, come out, let's study the property some, and we'll see. If we feel like we can do something, we'll complement the other two courses. That's all we ask. If we don't want to go build a golf course that can be perceived as, quote, totally the third course and no one wants to go play it. Now, yeah, obviously we didn't want to do that, but I said, let's look at it. Just came to the conclusion that we could do some interesting golf here, and it's going to be very different than the other two courses, and it'll start to reveal itself, and it will probably become more and more appreciated as time goes by, which seems to have proven out.
Trails is such an apt name for it. You've got mulch down on the paths. You've got all sorts of transitions between greens and tees through woods. You feel like you're on the Appalachian Trail. The signage, the wood fences, the halfway house, it all lends itself to this feeling you get that you were out amongst nature, you're out on a hike with your buddies.
Every hole is unto itself, pretty much. Like, you can't see another hole, really, from the hole you're on. And I think that is awesome, because every hole, then you walk out of this trail and it like unfolds before you. And you're like, oh my God, what is this one all about?
I love that point. There's a little walkway out to a plaque on up the hill from 13 before you tee off on 14. And it's like the best view on property. There's a bench up there too. If anybody's looking for one of the three best benches out here.
That's where Mike knew that his search was over. He found a site that matched his capacity for wonder. Gaze onto it.
I mean, what was your first impression? Standing up on the bluff there, what'd you think?
This is it.
Yeah.
It was that simple. The site was covered in gorse, so you didn't look out and see what you look out right here. I could see enough of the rumples to know that it was all sand, and it was just almost too good to be true.
Like, I don't think you could ever stand on that spot and not dream big things and be inspired by it. It gave me a Lewis and Clark type feeling, where you're standing up there and you're like, holy shit, there's the Pacific Ocean, man. We made it. The other four courses at Bandon, they're all on the water, right? And there's something about being next to 5,000 miles of the Pacific Ocean that is both humbling and energizing at the same time. I think Trails offers that same sense of humility and energy, but in a different way. It feels like more of a journey that you're on. Through all 18 holes of the course. The ocean is always going to get the headlines, but I think the soul of Bandon is on Trails.
Hey there, brother. How are you? Fresh socks,
fresh
shoes.
Fresh socks is clutch.
Fresh shirt. Feeling better. Feeling like a new man.
So I didn't realize, I'm kind of, playing with the 2 liters here.
True.
Ready to go low, though.
So yeah. Engage. Strike.
In an interesting twist, Sally and Randy got paired with two of the world's foremost female speed golfers. Randy doesn't exactly play speed golf, so that's an interesting juxtaposition.
My name is Amanda from Portland, Oregon. I love golf. That's my resume.
Oh, come on.
You're being modest.
2020 Oregon State. Amateur champion.
Okay.
Yeah.
Hey, I'm Gretchen Johnson, and I was a semifinalist in the USGA Mid-Am.
And what can we talk speed golf here too?
Oh, sure. He's the fastest golfer alive.
Like quite literally?
Possibly. So I shot even par 72 in 57 minutes.
Okay, let's go the other way.
With five clubs. Five clubs.
This is what we're going to be dealing with all day, just darts.
Ready, three.
I saw Ricky Fowler stroke there at the end. That was a good four.
The first truly handsome par five I'd ever seen.
The par five.
It's like, it's just, it's the George Clooney par five.
All day, baby.
I'm kicked. All day.
That's two golf shots in under 30 seconds.
That's
this is such a Murphy's Law golf course for me. Every, like if there's a good bounce it could take and a bad bounce, I always seem to get the bad bounce. Like, hey, it kicks right a little bit right behind these like little shrubs.
Your luck's got to turn.
I'm trying to flip the script today.
Your luck's got to turn.
I'm going to keep a positive attitude.
I love where you're headed.
But it soured me 2 years ago, so.
Great putt.
The fourth hole. It's you drive it up over this crest, and you're playing a pretty demanding second shot into just a really beautiful, gentle green.
Five was one of the holes that I was really, really, really concerned about heading into the trip. I'm like, God, lefty, like force carry. It was shorter than I remembered it, so that helped.
What a shot.
If the pin's in front, you look like you've got to hit it within a 4 foot landing spot. It's just an exhilarating shot, and it's demanding, but also fair.
Go in. Beach. Oof.
Oh my God.
Woo.
Beautiful.
All you need.
That's it.
That's dead center.
That's dead center.
She walked it in. I can't.
As a walk it in enthusiast, I can't take that one away from you.
Birdie for Tron.
We're birdieing the signature fucking holes today, baby. Come on. And then for the next 11 or 12 holes, like DJ proceeds to just basically flag everything.
Yeah.
Perfect.
I'm in vibing out.
Oh, love the trails.
Oh, folks, he's carving one. The Artis is back.
Private property tucked in the corner there. Kaiser wanted to buy that as soon as he bought the original. They said no. 257 to that pin. Let's see what Tron has.
Oh, that's in our house, dude. Seriously.
On the back deck.
Oh my God, it's in the hole. Heck. Hang on.
Go.
Oh, I got it. What a shot.
Dry.
Up the trail.
Woo.
Down.
How are you holding that? What is this?
Just trying to fucking like find some deep energy, something. I need like EMT paddles. I'm feeling a little jebby.
A little faded?
Yeah. So sometimes you just gotta like.
What is it? Ujjayi breathing?
Ujjayi breathing through the nose.
Yeah. The engine. Cool. You guys have made 4 birdies in 6 holes?
Yeah, that's a good
well,
time.
Yeah, so.
That's pretty tough.
You got a big
left. That's tough to beat. Oh, the mega flop.
Carter.
I mean, that's truly exceptional. God, what an up and down.
Cut!
Drawn for birdie at 8.
Oh! That felt pretty center cut, man. I can't see it, but if that was in the center, that's good by me.
How many is that? 3 today? 3 and 8 holes?
4 and 8 holes.
4 and 8 holes?
Love this golf course. Love this golf course. Little squid. Squid's like a 4-shot advantage. Yeah. So.
Come on. Do it.
Gosh. Oh, baby.
Oh,
yes,
another.
I need to get down.
Be as good as you.
I need to get down.
Sit.
Oh.
Sit.
Oh, God. My goodness.
Nine is really, really cool. The way it sits up there in the trees get bigger and bigger. The higher up there you get towards the green, there's a massive, massive tree up by the green as well. That's just, it sets the tone for the entire hole.
I'm getting laughed by in the Hungara ring by these guys, so I need a little rally cap. Need a little, some good island party boy vibes to, you know, spark some joy.
What happened on that drive?
I got stuck between the Tyler Durden, I want you to hit me as hard as you can, and the second serve ball. So it produces this like spinny Leviathan thing.
It's the double fault ball.
That'll be all right.
So after just talking about how they're delight to caddy for, is the tee shots?
This is the definition of caddy golf.
This is the first 3-wood of the trip.
You have good vibes here.
I do have great vibes. I eagled here a couple years ago.
Oh, baby.
Stay loud.
Woo! Yeah. Oh, I can't hit it any better than that.
Uh-huh.
Hell yeah.
Neil for eagle on number 9.
Do it.
Woo! Let's go. Woo! That was my nature, boys. God, the rally cap's on.
Played it twice. Six strokes.
Go. Go, go, go.
Love it. Oh my goodness. What did you guys shoot as a team? Like 30?
Really fun 9 holes of golf there. That gets him to 22 of his 33 points. I had a bit of a nice 9 there myself, even par. 23 of my 28, so I'm minus 5. Tron is at 9 of his 15, minus 6. So we are...
We're in the keys.
We're vibing. Yeah, I don't know what the boys are doing back there, but I haven't heard much screaming, so.
It's about to just go to another level, like 10 or 13.
Onward.
I was one on, not even.
I was telling Neil, I felt like I had to tithe after that 9. Made the turn to 10 and was wholly uncomfortable. I've been under par before, but not quite having it going like that. And it just felt like, hey man, like that's enough. Why don't you give a little bit back? Why don't you give a little bit back to us? So just the grossest, most brain dead double three putt, horrible. And then you back to one over. Okay, now you go ahead. Go have fun.
Got a little rubber the green situation here.
Yeah, what happened?
Came over it. Bounces once, hops, big bounce, and hangs up here in the tree.
I mean, in just the truest sense of the term, TC, that is the rub of the green.
Oh, so good. Go!
He's potting!
How about that,
folks? Hey! Hit 4, dude.
Hit 4, brother!
Catch the trail on the way up for a second.
Oh, wow. Really sticking with the trail theme.
Gosh, yeah, 14 is the most talked about hole at Bandon, probably, and not for good reasons.
14 sucks ass.
I think 14's sweet. No. I'm going to birdie it tonight, for sure.
Like 300 to 320 yard par 4. If it plays shorter than that, so I would say 90% of the shots are probably going to end up in the same exact place. Probably 40 or 50 feet uphill to one of the narrowest greens you've ever seen, with a cavernous bunker front right and a death drop off back left.
It is what it is. I mean, you have to hit 2 really good shots to hold the green, but this is not supposed to be fair. It's gone.
Bill and Ben have moderated it somewhat. The way that Ben, that's Ben's hole, the way that Ben built it with the squeezed in bunker left and really penal bunkers to the right. Most lousy golfers ended up going from one to the other to the other. But to their credit, Bill and Ben heard that, and it took me some lobbying, but they have mellowed it, moving the left bunker quite a bit left.
Throw in the towel, stop the fight.
You think about it before you get there. You think about it while you're on the tee. It's polarizing. I don't really like it, but I also respect it, and I think it's an integral part of like the fabric of the course.
Yeah,
nice.
Pretty easy hole.
The shortest par five on the golf course.
15, just a really cool driving hole, great cross bunkering, exceptional green sight up there sitting in this little pocket. Just a exhilarating two shot hole.
Very nice.
You know, 16, it's tough. It's tougher to like an uphill par five. That's a really, really cool green. And you got to hit, you know, you got to be in control of your distance. It's a nice examination at the end of a round or near the end of a round.
Not very good.
Okay. Hey, you went for it. It's worked out well for you so far.
What's the ruling?
We've got all sorts of stuff going on here. We've got some sort of dangerous insect down here. So I was thinking about hitting it right-handed. Obviously, I'd get relief.
Show me the bug again.
It's right here.
And take your stance?
Which one?
You know, Tron, I just don't see any way that's a dangerous situation.
You want to hit a cut right here, right? So if I want to right here, I mean, that's pretty darn close.
We're trying to swoop this thing.
I mean, we're...
Well, that's fine. What is it, a club? I mean, isn't it a club length? And then you're dropping on the 45-degree angle?
You think so?
Yeah. Climb.
Sorry, I had to break out the bad boy pretty good.
10 feet for eagle? Like, is that good? I don't know. I think so. We'll see what Deech does. He might stuff the pinata here.
10 feet. Oh, God. Ice cold. No mistakes. You like that.
Six birdies.
To both left, first of all scoring a match, so.
What do you think of playing a match against these ladies?
It's really hard. They don't miss, they don't make any mistakes. It's been fun though. I think it's really engaged me mentally, so I've quite enjoyed it.
17 is like truly the crescendo of the round, or just a perfect downhill par three. It's the closest I've felt to playing golf in Melbourne, Australia, without being in Melbourne, Australia.
Between us, if DJ birdies this, he will birdie all four. Squid said he's never seen that here before. So try to keep the pressure off.
Go. Just hit the crap. Go.
It's always fun when you have somebody playing really well in your group and it pushes everybody else to play better.
Did you know that it would have been a big feat if you'd played all four?
I did.
The superfecta would have been cool.
The superfecta would have been cool. 8 strokes for 4 par threes would have been cool. Me and Squid were talking about that at 5. I think that's what we said walking up. Let's get them all.
I still think 3 out of 4 is still, that still might be a record.
Whew. Update, DJ, that par moves him to 39 plus 11.
Wow.
I think we're in the open field officially.
DJ, lead us off.
Alright.
And then we get to 18. DJ, we're a little bit pressed for time, and we look up and Kaiser is standing up on the left dune up behind the green. And then basically hits his second shot, rushes up, two putts, and runs off to do the basis for what episode 3 would become.
There's a pot in here.
This pipe's going down the middle.
Good luck.
Come on, let's finish him off.
3 for 2.
Wow.
Great ball.
I thought we were getting a twirl on that one.
Oh, God, where is that?
That was a little Monty at Wingfoot. What is that?
Good try, man. Lost some patience.
Good putt.
Just friendly.
He begs for the gimme and gets it. To win the match. That's the first thing that's hit the hole all day.
After you finish up at Trails, you get to go have a beer in the Trails clubhouse, which it's not even close how much better that clubhouse is than anything else on property. I would be remiss if I didn't mention DJ 72.
Not one, not two, not three, not four, not five. It's 6 birdies today.
God, 6 birdies. Thank you.
It's rare that you see someone play their best and also score their best. Like sometimes it's, you know, they're hitting the ball really well, but that doesn't match up scoring-wise. And he was doing everything well. He was in total control. He was putting well.
Career love.
Career love.
Career love.
I know that's like
two doubles? With 72 with 2 doubles.
If anybody says you should skip Trails, like that person is an idiot. I wouldn't skip it because it's the best golf course of the bunch.
It's hard to beat golf on the ocean. It's kind of unfair. But of all the courses, it's the most interesting. Punch you in the face strategy. Like, you forgot about me, motherfucker, bunkers, you know. Like we've said before, it's tantric out there.
It just feels like the best elements of going on a hike and reflecting in nature and going and spending 4 hours with your buddies. I don't think it's necessarily the best golf experience at Bandon, but I think it's A, the best golf course, and it's my favorite golf experience at Bandon.
Good job, man.
It's all right.
You sure?
I'll just go fuck myself on the way up.